not bode well. Now he's going to have to stay up with him all night. Oh, God. Then he takes me to a fast food joint for dinner and discovers he's forgotten his wallet. So I'm there sitting there watching this guy talk with his mouth full, all right, the full washing machine is there. I'm thinking, seriously, I just paid for plastic cutlery on a first date and I shaved for this? Oh, I couldn't wait to get home and read a book. But he's a gentleman, he insisted on walking me home. I held my breath as he came in for the goodbye hug. I no longer hear a damn word he's saying because my entire focus has just migrated to the thing that reaches at least 3/4 of the way down my eye! Oh my God! I have got to check this out. Now, I know I can't just grab it. I'm not We're talking a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity here. Not only that, we're talking about encountering a mythical creature. Oh, yes, indeed. But all I could hear in the back of my mind is my girlfriend screaming at me down the phone the next morning, "You passed up on a guy hung like a horse. What is wrong with you? How are we going to know about these things?" And in keeping with true hypocrisy, within 5 minutes of wishing he'd bugger off never to be seen again, he's by my bedside in just his boxers, and I'm trying desperately not to stare, because as God is my waitress, I would have given anything to order a slow motion action replay right then, because we are talking a genuine ankle spanker. The guy should have been in porn movies. Maybe he was. Oh my God. But see now, my mind has just zipped right over to calculating dimensions. And my Gina has something to say about it. What are you? I'm drunks! Can you not see the size of that thing? Girl, your eyes are bigger than your snatch.